Thank you. silent, vibrating, or even in the hall position would be preferable. But we do understand emergencies may come up. Shall we stand? The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear. Even though the earth be removed and though the mountains be carried in the midst of the sea. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, neither faints nor is weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases their strength. Even the youth shall be weary. The young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up on wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would not have told you. I go and prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself. That where I am, there you may be also. And where I go, you know. And the way you know. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you're going, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Jesus said unto her, John 11:25, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he may die, yet shall he live. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet will sound. And the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption. This mortal must put on immortality. So when And this corruptible has put on incorruption, and this mortal hath put on immortality. Then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your sting? O grave, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be unto God, who giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. For we know that if our earthly house, this tent, is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. So we are always confident, knowing that
while we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. Christ died and rose again. Even so, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep. For this we say to you, the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord shall not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet of God. And the dead in Christ shall rise first. Yes, then we who are alive and remain, yes, shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And thus shall always we be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. I have fought a good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Finally, there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me on that day, and not to me only, but also to all who have loved his appearing. Then one of the elders answered, saying to me, who are these arrayed in white robes? And from whence did they come? And I said unto him, sir, you know. And he said unto me, these are the ones who come out of great tribulation, and washed their robes, and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore, they are before the throne of God, and serve him day and night in his temple. And he who sits on the throne will dwell among them. They shall neither hunger anymore, nor thirst anymore. The sun shall not strike them, nor any heat. For the Lamb who was in the midst of the throne will shepherd them and lead them to living fountains of water. And God shall wipe away every tear from their eyes. Then I heard a voice from heaven saying to me, write, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on. Yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, and their works do follow them. Oh, I want to see him look upon his face. Everybody, there to see forever. Oh, you may be seated. Oh, on the streets of glory, let me lift my voice. Oh, cares on. If you know it, help me say it, everybody. Oh, I want to see. Oh, yeah. There. On the streets of glory, there to lift my voice. Oh, cares on. One more time, everybody, help me say, oh, I want to see, look upon, oh, there, oh, singing on, oh, yeah, help me say, cares.
Amen. 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 Let the church say amen. Amen. I know it is good to be in the house of the Lord. Just one more time. Amen. Amen. We have come to celebrate the life of Mrs. Chyna Hudson. This 31st, March 31st, 1919 through February 6th, 2022. This Sunday, February the 13th, 2022, 1 p.m. here at the Watkinson Garrets in Woods Mortuary. Reverend Dr. Byron Battle, senior eulogist. The program has been beautifully outlined. Amen? Amen. Amen. We have order of Eastern Star Ceremony, a solo, Take Me to the King, by Mrs. Chantel Battle, scripture reading, Old Testament, Psalms 113 by Reverend Carlton Austin, Pastor Mill Rock Baptist Church, New Testament, Philippians 4 and 4 and 9, Reverend Tyrone Westfield, pastor of the Stockton Community Baptist Church. And we have prayer by Reverend Dr. Stacy Mills, pastor of the Mountain View Baptist Church. Then solo, I Am Redeemed, by Sister Miss Cindy Vaughn, darling. And we will come back at that moment. But the program has been beautifully outlined. Once you see your name, please come up. Amen. 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 Thank you.
the beauty of a woman in her eyes, because that's the doorway to her heart, the place where love resides. The true beauty of a woman is reflected by her soul. It's the caring that she gives and the passion that she shows. And the beauty of a woman with passing years only grows. Sister China Hudson was not only a beautiful woman, but she portrayed all aspects of the heroines of our right. Through Ada, she showed the sanctity of a vow and was faithful to the beliefs of right in this degree. Through Ruth, she showed the virtue of faithful devotion to religious principles of obedience. Through Esther, she showed the praiseworthy quality of faithfulness and loyalty. Through Martha, she showed the hope of immortality and moral qualities of true, trustful faith in the time of trouble. And through Electa, she showed the courage of bearing wrong and injustice for the sake of truth. Now I will read the resolution. International Free and Accepting Martyr Masons Incorporated in the Order of Eastern Star. Illustrious Kenneth L. Hollowell, 33rd degree, Supreme President, CEO. Sister Monique C. Walton, Supreme Grand Matron. Resolution. In memory of Sister China Hudson. Whereas Sister China Hudson joined the International Free and Accepted Martyr Mason in the Order of Eastern Star, uniting with Mauldin number 90, January the 3rd, 1963, and then continued on with the Queen of the South, Exalted Degree, Lady Knights, Shrine, Rose College, and the Rose of Seven Seals. Her quest for knowledge and understanding led her to exemplify honesty, kindness, endurance, courage, and courtesy in the highest degree of the order. And whereas she was prepared to faithfully perform the duties and to accept the responsibilities of a true sister, her leadership capabilities were developed and utilized to the fullest. And whereas our golden circle of friendship was broken when Sister Hudson stepped to the other side of the River of Jordan on the sixth day of February 2022, answering the call of our Lord, he said, "The day is done, the work is finished, lay down your tools and come to the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world." And whereas we may no longer consult with her about our worldly affairs and problems, for she advised, taught, and consoled us on different aspects of life. She tried to speak a word of hope and to lend a hand that would help and never hinder. We will always remember and feel her comforting presence and know she watches over us. And whereas we are poorer since Sister Hudson left us, heaven is richer now that she is there. Her voice that we loved is silent. Now is still are her helpful hands. We know that God will use them both in his heavenly land. Therefore, be it resolved. Sister Hudson is waiting for us in the city of peace, and we count on God's words. For he said, "I will never fail you nor forsake you." We find strength in these words and are enabled to bury our selfish grief. We offer this testimony of our sympathy and sorrow to the family. And be it further resolved, we, the members of Mauldin number 90, rejoice in the times we shared with Sister Hudson. Proverbs 16 and 9 states, "A man's heart chooses his way, but God directed his steps." Our hearts are glad Sister Hudson chose International Mason in the Order of Eastern Star, and that God directed her steps our way. We find comfort and hope that the family and friends can find the same comfort in knowing that she is no longer sick and suffering, but well and happy with our Lord. She is tenderly loved and protected from sickness, evil, and wrong. She eagerly awaits us at heaven's doors, secure in the knowledge that death is but the beginning of life. We who have known and loved her and whose passing has brought sad tears will cherish her memory always to brighten the passing years. Spiritually submitted this 13th day of February 2022, Sister Martina Durham, Grand Matron of South Carolina.
Oh, yeah. the lessons that we've learned, and coming with this sister, let us, at this time, we shall hear the right, the lessons of these rites that I just want her to know. Sister Ada.
Blue represents faithfulness. As Jessica's daughter, who in the springtime of her life heroically gave her own for her father's honor. As a token of our faithful love for our sister, I deposit this flower.
To her people, risk her life to save them, bringing joy to the nation. As a token of our, as a token of appreciation for our departed sister, I deposit this flower in her casket.
Immortality and inspires a hope of a life beyond the grave. As Martha showed in her splendid belief in God at the death of her brother Lazarus, so we cling to a hope of a resurrection in the radiant future of our departed sister. I deposit this evergreen.
Of fervency. With religious fervor, Electa befriended the needy and endured persecution. In a token as our fervent relationship for our sister, in her casket, I deposit this flower.
Sister Hudson, a person that I've known for many years.
So Father, we ask that you just give them strength to go through and give the chapters strength to endure this loss. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray.
Amen. So may it be, so may it be, so may it be.
Request that she take this with her. key. I don't have much to breathe. My heart is torn in pieces. It's my offering. Please take me to the King. Truth is, I'm tired. Heart is, I'm tired. Options are few. I'm trying to pray, but where are you? I'm all churched out, hurt and abused. I can't fake what's left to do. Truth is, I'm weak, no strength to fight. No tears to cry, even if I tried. But still my soul refuses to die. One touch can change my life. So take me to the King. I don't have much to breathe. My heart's torn in pieces. It's my offering. Lay me at the throne. Leave me there alone to gaze upon your glory and sing to you the song. Please take me to the King. Truth is, it's time to stop playing these games. We need a word for the people's pain. So Lord, speak right now. Let it fall like rain. Oh yeah, we're desperate. We're chasing after you. Oh, no rules, no religion. And I've made my decision to run to you, the healer that I need. Take me to the King. I don't have much to breathe. My heart is torn to pieces. It's my offering. So lay me at the throne and leave me there alone to gaze upon your glory and to sing to you this song. Lord, we're in the way. We keep making mistakes. The glory's not for us. It's all for you. Take me to the King. I don't have much to breathe. My heart is torn to pieces. It's my offering. Oh, lay me at the throne. I want you to leave me there alone. Lord, I want to gaze upon your glory and sing to you this song. Take me to the King. Take me to the King. Take me to the King. I
Praise ye the Lord. Praise all you servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord from this time forth and forevermore. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the Lord's name is to be praised. The Lord is high above all nations, and his glory above the heavens. Who is likened unto the Lord our God, who dwelleth on high, who humbled himself to behold the things that are in heaven and in earth. He's risen up the poor out of the dust, yes, and he lifted up the needy out of the dunghill, that he may set him with princesses, even the princes of his people. Mm-hmm. He maketh the barren woman to keep house and to be a joyful mother of her children. Praise ye the Lord.
Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I will say, rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to all men. The Lord is at hand. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Finally, my brethren, whatever things are true, whatever things are noble, whatever things are just, whatever things are pure, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are good of good report, if there is any virtue, and if there's anything praiseworthy, meditate on these things. These things which you learned and received, heard and saw in me, these do. And the God of peace will be with you. May this word add a comfort to this family at this time.
Let us bow together in prayer. Heavenly Father, we bow in this moment to give you thanks. Lord, we honor you because you are God, and from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. You are Jehovah Jireh. You are Jehovah Sitkanu. You are Jehovah Rapha. You are Elohim. You are El Shaddai. And even in this moment, you are the one who gives life, and you are the only one who can take it. You promised us 70 years and 10, and that by reason of good health. And so today, while our heads are bowed within the locks of our shoulders, and while grief is looming over our heads, we realize that you did better than the promise. We thank you for the life of Mother China Hudson. We thank you that you exceeded our expectations. And even while the family grieves, we still rejoice because you've shown your faithful hand. Master, we pray in the days ahead that they too will rejoice, that they too will look back over their life life and realize that you've been better than good. We thank you, Master, for grandchildren and great-grandchildren who stand on the shoulders of their great-grandmother and now realize that a legacy has been passed to them. Now, Father, we pray that you would stir up the gifts, that we might worship you in this tabernacle, that we might honor you because you are good, and besides you there is no other. We will lift up our eyes unto the hills from which cometh our help, for our help comes from you. Now help this family, these daughters and children and grandchildren. Be with them and strengthen them for the days ahead. And Lord, I pray for this preacher, this pastor who will stand in this sacred place. Sanctify preaching for this moment, that our ears may be open to understand and that our hearts may be better. We thank you now, Lord, for we realize that you've given us a home beyond these shores where the builder and maker is not man. And so we thank you for that promise fulfilled in the life of Mother Hudson. Let it be so now. In Jesus' name we pray, and we thank you, Master, for even in this, you're still God. Amen and praise God.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
You know, when I chose this song, it's because my niece didn't want to hear Amazing Grace. I can't sing something other than Amazing Grace. But it was grace that took my mother. And grace will lead us on. But I sing this song because it was befitting for my mother. Because what other than redemption? You got to know about salvation. For a woman who couldn't read and write, she knew who Jesus was. And she taught her children. Jesus, he changed my whole life. Ooh. And if anybody asked you just who I am, tell them for me, tell them I am redeemed. Oh, where there was hate, you know love now abides. And where there's confusion, peace now reigns. Oh, yes, it does. You see, I'm walking with Jesus. I'm a child of the King. And it's because, oh, it's because I've been redeemed. Now let me tell you about my mama. You see, China was redeemed. She was bought with a price. You see, it was Jesus. Oh, he changed her whole life. if anybody asks you, oh, who my mama was, yes, I want you to tell them that child, oh, she was redeemed. Oh, I say, mama, you were redeemed. Yes, my mama, she was redeemed. My mama was redeemed by his blood. Oh, and anybody asks you just who she was, you from church, China Hudson, she was redeemed.
Glory to God.
Let the church say hallelujah. How about if anybody asks you, what would you tell them? Will you tell them you were redeemed? Bought with a price. Did Jesus change your whole life? Let the church say hallelujah. This is the time to give him praise for a life that we're celebrating. Yeah. Amen. He said, I give you life, and I give you life more abundantly. But you're going to receive that life if you are redeemed. So if anybody asks you, will you tell them that you was bought with a price, that you are redeemed? Let the church say, amen. We come to celebrate. We come to celebrate a life that has been so well lived. At this moment, we will have remarks. The family wishes and desires that you take 3 minutes. Amen. Can I get amen again? Amen. And for the third time for the 3 minutes. Can I get amen again? Amen. Amen. So we all know it's 3 minutes. Amen. Amen. We will have remarks from Noel Marion, goddaughter, Sister Gertrude Rose Gray, Order of the Eastern Star, and Cullie Dawson, daughter. And after that, we have solo by Miss Marsha McKinney Campbell, When I Wake Up in Glory. Then we have the Words of Comfort by Reverend Dr. Byron L. Batter, Sr. Then we have a selection by Sambula Land by Reverend Dr. Stacy D. Mills. Then representation, Tabernacle Baptist Church and reception. Please, this order has been beautifully outlined. If you see your name appear, amen, come forth.
Pardon me, this is a day of interruption. We did not expect China to go, but I'm Russell. I have been with this family for close to 50 years, and I'm going to give you some inside information. You only hear what you see on the pictures, but I'm your inside man. Of all the sisters and brothers that I've known, I've never seen one harsh word or body from him. That shows you that you had a mother that only displayed love for her family. As I look over these years, we can count them. almost 25 presidents, 5 wars, she got her family through every one of those miseries, all right? Then, here you have a woman that, for me, always displayed what love really was. It's not to shake your booty. It's not the baby, I love you all night long. Go and please, ladies and gentlemen, for the rest of your lives, this is your moment. Within this lady's 104 years, the 2 years is incorrect. Within her 104 years, this is the true definition of love, Corinthians 1:13. This tells you the heart of God. Always teach your children this. Although she spoke with the tongue of women and angels, and she always showed love, she was not a tinkling cymbal. Although sometimes to us, it seemed like she could heal every misery that we had, and she always showed love. Although there were some mysteries we never understood, Miss China had an answer, and she always showed love. She was never unkind, always kind, always had heart, always forgave, always the woman there to give relief. And you know, she told me once, when she was a child, she lived as a child. But when she became a woman, she had to put away the childish things of the woman and become that mother. She had become that healer. She had become that wife. She had become that comforter. All the things that all of her women and her men children needed. Then, she says, one day, Russell, right now I can't see through that glass. Hey, but you know what? She sees now. She sees now what's on the other side. Of all the women, including my mother, that I have knew in life, no one showed more faith, more hope. And what God wants us all to show each other is love. And this is what God told me himself, because I was greatly sad. If I'm wrong, preachers, correct me. He took away the keys from death. Is that correct? So does that mean there is no death? And he said, Russ, I'm going to tell you what I gave her as the greatest gift in the universe. Eternal life. Amen. Hallelujah, bro. Amen.
I met Miss China more than 30 years ago. My sister and I were with Cindy when she stopped to see her. She was kind enough to offer us something to eat, and we were more than happy to accept. After learning when her birthday was, I asked her what kind of cake she liked and her favorite ice cream. That next year, a few days before her birthday, I called and asked if it was okay if I stopped by for a visit. She said, yeah, because it's my birthday. I said, yes, ma'am, I remembered. I showed up with a homemade pound cake and a half gallon of what I considered the best strawberry ice cream on the market. Today, the brand escapes me. She was happily surprised and set off to get plates. She always wanted me to cut the cake and would say, give me a nice size piece. I'd add a nice serving of ice cream and our celebration and gab fest would begin. Our tradition continued for many years, with one that included my 3 granddaughters and my being warned by my 10-year-old that her almost 1-year-old sister wasn't supposed to have ice cream because it would make her lactose intolerant. one of the honors of being a grandparent is that we get away with some things. Well, I didn't get away with it. I confirmed yesterday that my now almost 19-year-old is lactose intolerant. Have you ever met someone that made you feel so special that your heart smiled so big that your eyes watered? Well, allow me to share just a few. When attending a banquet for seniors, I overheard Miss China telling those at her table, "That's my goddaughter over there," pointing at me. Miss China thanked me for being such a good friend to her daughter. Being announced when I came to visit Miss China with, "Your other daughter is here." When I called Miss China to let her know what day I was coming, she would say, "Oh, it's the birthday." And I would hear the joy in her voice. She even told me once that she told a few relatives who had called that Novella is coming because it's the birthday. I gotta go. My name is Noel, but Miss China called me Novella. She gave me the title of goddaughter. She gave me credit for being a good friend. She gave me the blessing of becoming an honorary and beloved member of her earthly family. Now that heaven is her home, I take solace in knowing that when my time here is done, I will once again see her big, contagious smile, hear her joy-filled laughter, and celebrate in eternity. On March 31st, I encourage all of you to have a nice size piece, a homemade pound cake, with a nice serving of your favorite ice cream, and say out loud, "It's the birthday." Peace and blessings to all.
I give honor to my Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, to the Hudson family, to the International Masons and Order of Eastern Star, free and accepted Martyr Mason and Order of Eastern Star, and friends. It is with pleasure that I stand to say a few remarks on my friend. In years past, was my neighbor on McCall Street. Jocelyn, her granddaughter, and my daughter attended Benedict College with the owner of the Walking Garrets and Woods Mortuary, Doug, and they always let me know about Felicia. And I didn't get up to talk about Felicia. But I must say this, 6 years ago, this day, I stood here and made remarks for my daughter. And here I am, Sister China, to say some funny things about her. Now, those of you that knew China, I'm 78, so I know there's a lot of you that have known her longer than I. And I've been in the Masons, Eastern Stars for 53 years. And China was one of the ones, back in the day is when they called it initiation. Now we confer degrees. She and some of the older members in the order, I have someone here that can attest to the place that we used to meet on Hudson Street. above the garage there, where China and some of her friends took me through. And I could not remember if I went in the same door that I came out of. It took me 3 meetings to realize that I was in the same place. China was a part of that. Those of you also that know Miss China know that she loved to talk. One of our grandmasters carried her to Hilton Head, and he was so happy to get Miss China back home. He said it was a 5-hour trip there, a 5-hour trip back, and she talked both ways for the whole 10 hours. If you know China, that's Miss China. Well, one of the funniest things that I can remember, Sister Hudson traveled and could wear some of the whitest uniforms. Her shoes would be like she didn't even touch the ground. They were so white. And we back then was wearing a blue cape. And Miss China would have her regalia on and her uniform, and she would have that cape flipped back over her shoulder. You couldn't touch Miss China. But we went to the Bahamas several times, and she and I traveled to Canada together. But from one of our trips in the Bahamas, when we got back, landed in Miami, Sister Hudson, we went down to retrieve our bags. And Sister Hudson saw this little white man walking through the corridor of the airport. She turned around to Sister Williams and said, "He got my bag." And let me tell you something. China ran the man all the way through the airport, made him open his bag to prove to her that it wasn't hers. And the thing that proved it was, when he opened it, she saw men underwear. So that let us know that it wasn't China's. But needless to say, our 18 hours from Miami, Florida to Greenville was all about Miss China and running across the airport. I just want to let you know that Miss China was one of my favorite people. I went to visit her on Thursday night. I had prayer with her, and I left her with this song. What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see, when I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by my hand and leads me to the promised land, what a day. China's gonna say this, it will be. What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see, when I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by my hand and leads me to the promised land, what a day, glorious day that will be.
Amen. Well, this is not a spot I wanted to be at, but I needed you to know who my mother is. Miss Hudson gave birth to 7 daughters. She raised 7 others, 3 girls and 3 boys. She had a house full of people at all times. She loved people beyond belief. She had no color in her man. It was just by your name. That's what she addressed you as. There's no black, there's no white. That's just whatever your name is in my mother's life. Mama never learned to read or write. She only had a 2nd grade education. But when we moved back from McCall Street to Calhoun Street to Spencer Street, Endale Street, and back to McCall Street, Mama, we moved into a house that had an L-shaped front porch. Well, Daddy closed that porch in, so we had a little sunroom, so we thought. It became our prayer room. Mama had a little record player, and she had a Bible. And we read that Bible to her. We learned about Jesus. She made it a part of our lives. We sang songs from her little record player, Mahalia Jackson, whoever else. And we learned, we had a choir practice. Nobody knew a note, but we sang. She had a cafe on Greasy Corner, Small Paradise Diner, with a 2nd grade education to an entrepreneur. To say that anything that you choose to or do in life, you can do it. My mother never, ever did anything that was out of order. She wore us a brand new one because Daddy grew switches on the side of the house on many a day. So we learned how to behave, and it's important, one thing that Mama would like for me to say yes, sir, and yes, ma'am. It does not cause you to be any lesser of an individual. It makes you stronger in the eyes of other people. If you give respect, you get respect. Amen. For all the young men that are in our family, my father was a stickler for dress. Please stop wearing your pants below your equator. Pull them up. Become a true man. For the women of our household, learn to treat each other in a manner that Mama taught us to do. She didn't teach us hatred. She taught us love. I want us to carry out that love in us. For those of us that have a discord in your heart, in your mind, your spirit right now, give it to Jesus. Leave it alone. Let it go. We have no one to go to anymore for advice but Jesus. That's why God took her home. Dad died 30 years ago next month. Next month, Mama would have been 105. God let us have her 30 more years after Daddy died to prepare us for this day. Become adults in your heart, in your mind, and in your spirit. And stop allowing the small things to interrupt what you call life. Thank you.
I'm going to sing this song on my grandmama's side. Lord, I go, if I had to go, by myself. Lord, I go, if I had to go, by myself. If my mother
Here my father. Here my sister. Here my brother. Now I go. If I had to go. Hey, I had to go by myself. Look at him. Lord, I sing. If I had to sing, I had to sing by myself. Look at him. Lord, I pray. If I had to pray, I'm yeah, if my mother, or if my father, or if my sister, if my brother, Lord, I pray, if I had to pray, yeah, I had to pray by myself. Look at him. Send me. Oh, God, send me. Oh, to the hospital. Oh, to the nurse home. Oh, to the prison. On the highway. No more crying. Send me out the no more bills. Send me out the no more heartaches. Send me out the no more pain. Send me out the all the Jerusalem. I go if I had to go, yeah, I had to go by myself.
When I wake up in glory, and to Jesus I'll sing redemption story. Oh, yeah. Soul shall be free. be he who taught me how to be free. When I wake up in glory by and by. I think this is her message to you all. When my weary eyelids close and I sunk to sweet repose, I'm singing hallelujah, hallelujah, as I go.
Not our desire that one day when this old life is over, that we have a home, we have a building not made with hands, but eternal in the heavens. We are grateful this afternoon for all that has been said and all that has been done as it relates to the celebration of life for dear Mother Hudson. We're grateful that you and you are here. This family is appreciative of, and I'm sure they will thank you at a later date for all that has been said and all that has been done. I'm going to ask two things just before we go right into the word of the Lord. With the exception of the Reverend clergy behind us and in the choir stand, if there are any ministers or pastors that are in the audience, please stand so that this family can see you. Any pastors, any ministers, please stand. Amen. Will you give God praise for these men and women of God, please? Amen. You may be seated. Let me kind of cut across the field, too, so that we can continue to be good stewards of our time. On your program, you will see a presentation from the Tabernacle Baptist Church. If it's all right, family, I'm going to go ahead and do that now so that We can minister the word of the Lord for just a few moments, and then we can have our closing song and be prepared to leave this place. What a joy and a privilege it was to, and still is, to have Mother Hudson as a member for over 70 years, a member of the Tabernacle Baptist Church. And we are grateful. Amen. Let's give God praise for that. To this entire family, and of course, to all of you who are here, we have a plaque that I want to read. I'm not going to read all of it. It's kind of lengthy. But when you live a life like Mother Hudson, you know, her life just spoke for herself. And so we just want you to know our hearts were saddened to hear about the death of our member and your loved one, Sister China Lee Hudson. We share your grief and extend to you our love and sympathy. As you know, it is never the right time to lose a loved one, but as Christians, we believe that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. Be encouraged in knowing that the officers and members of Tabernacle Baptist Church, Greenville, South Carolina, are praying for you and your family, that the Lord will comfort and strengthen each of you in your hour of bereavement. May God's love and peace surround you as you remember the wonderful moments that God allows your loved one to spend with you. Remember that those who live in the hearts of others never die. Let us continue to work towards meeting her again. Please know that we are only a prayer away if you should need any assistance. May God continue to bless and keep each of you in his care. Sincerely, yours truly, Senior Pastor of Tabernacle Baptist Church. Tabernacle, would you please stand, if you will, so that this family can see the strength and love and support. God bless you. Give Tabernacle a great hand. Bless you all. Just want to, of course, there are many churches here that are represented, but certainly we have the joy and privilege of calling Sister Hudson our member, and for that we are grateful. To all of the Reverend clergy that are present, of course, to my covenant brother, Pastor Stacy Mills, we give God praise for all of you who are here. Now, we recognize that we've been here for a moment. This is also Super Bowl Sunday. My team didn't make it, so I'm gonna preach at least an hour. No, but again, we're certainly grateful again to all of the Reverend clergy. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, there is one verse of scripture that I want to share with you that will give you a clue as to how long I'll be up here preaching. There's one verse of scripture that we want to share with prayerfully will comfort the family and all those who are in bereavement at this hour. 2 Corinthians chapter number 5, verse 1. Listen to what Paul declares in his second epistle to the church at Corinth. He says, "For we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, we have a building of God, a house not made with hands, but eternal in the heavens." I want to preach for just a few moments from this thought. You lost the house, but you still have a home. You lost the house, but you still have a home. Now, this is the general message that the Apostle Paul is sharing in his second epistle, this short letter to the church at Corinth, which began in Anno Domini AD 52. Paul visited there on his second missionary journey, and Paul stayed there about 1.5 years, for his second letter to the church at Corinth is riddled with instructions, but Paul is also going to take a moment and express his relief and joy that the Corinthians had actually received his first letter with joy and with gladness and in such a positive manner. Now, by the time we arrive at chapter 5 in this, what we call, some call, second edition to the letter, we are well assured that by faith there is another life after this one has ended.
But Paul has, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, he has hope through grace of heaven as a dwelling place, a resting place, a hiding place, if you will. If you remember in that non-synoptic gospel of John, chapter 14, verse 2, you remember he said, in my Father's house are many mansions whose builder and maker is God. The happiness of the future state is what God is preparing for all of us who say that we are Christians and we love God with all of our heart, mind, and soul. The happiness of this future state is what God has prepared for us, because we have cried today. We are going to cry some more. We're going to mourn. We are going to grieve. But what makes this thing called Christianity confusing to those who can't really grasp the Christian principles is that we can cry and shout at the same time. We can rejoice, yet tears can fall from our eyes, because we know that where Mother Hudson is, one day we soon will be. The old folk, you say it like this, you just got to keep setting up your timber each and every day. These earthly tabernacles that are susceptible to headaches, high blood pressure, diabetes, cancer, not like these poor cottages of clay in which our souls now dwell. They're moldering, they're decaying over time. The foundations are dust, for we were formed out of the dust, and to the dust we shall return. Please understand, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, as I prepare to close now, in the opening verse, just in the opening verse of the text I read to you, Paul teaches you and I as Christians, as followers of the teachings of Christ, that even though we deal with an earthly loss, y'all excuse me, I'm about to get happy. I'm not really sure if that's appropriate at a funeral. It does not compare to what we shall receive. Now, one of the things about Mother Hudson we have to understand, because a lot of times people live, Methuselah lived 900 plus years, didn't do nothing. But 104 years, God gave this precious woman of God. And I just believe that not only did she not meet a stranger, but she exhibited the characteristics of those of us who say we love Christ ought to do. Because you do understand there's a difference between somebody going to church and a Christian. Oh, I think we're going to be surprised, y'all, when we get to heaven, because there's some people who we just knew were going to be there. And they may not be there. And then there's some people who we just knew weren't going to be there. Those are the very ones that are going to be there. My father, James Battle, who graduated from Sterling High School in 1966, he used to say to me all the time, he said, son, he said, don't ever judge a book by its cover. Because man looketh on the outward appearance, but it is God who judges the heart. Yeah, what may be Little House on the Prairie one day may be Nightmare on Elm Street the next day. You can never look at somebody and judge the sum total of their life. It's what's in the heart. Let the church say it's in the heart. It's in the heart. Please understand your date of origin, which is your birthday, and your date of expiration, which will be afforded to the majority of us in the room. There's a dash that's in between. And that dash is more significant than your birthday. Because at that point, it is not the day you were born. It is not the day you expire. But what did you do while you had life and breath in your body? And I believe there are a few of us in here that have matured to the point now where we are starting to discover that stuff we really stress over and worry about really doesn't matter. Because at the end of the day,
I wish I had a witness right back here in that section right there. As long as God is pleased at the end of the day, as long as you are doing all that you can do to survive and to do what it is God wants you to do. Y'all heard the record. You heard the story. She may not have been able to read and write, but guess what? She had discernment like none other. She could look at you and tell what you were all about. She could look at you, Cullie, you know I'm going to be me. She could look at you and tell what was going on. How else could she raise all of her children and take on some of the neighborhood's children? She taught folk that there was a difference between being a female and being a lady. They're two totally different things. There's a difference between being a female and being a lady, because being female is a matter of gender, but being a lady is a matter of choice. Sister Hudson could have walked in the room. She didn't have to be loud. She did not have to announce her presence. All she had to do was walk in the room and the atmosphere would change. She commanded respect. She made the world respect her God. And I need to tell about 10 of y'all sitting in the room as I get ready to close. You need to stop worrying and sweating small stuff, because the last time I checked, God is the only one I know who is the author of time and space. Hold on, I'll be with you in a minute. God is the only one who is the author of time and space. And if he said it, it's going to come to pass. I need to tell 5 of y'all in here, don't y'all worry about what the devil apparently may be trying to do to your family or do in your job situation, because not only is he a liar, he is also the father of lies, which means that if he says something, it's got to be the exact opposite. So if he tell you you're going to be sick the rest of your life, evidently you're getting ready to walk into some healing. If he tell you you're going to be broke the rest of your life, evidently you're getting ready to come into more than you've ever had before. Don't concentrate on what's happening. Just focus on what God said. He's the only one I know. He's the only one I know that tells you that if you're going to get something in this life, you're going to have to do the opposite of what the world requires you to do. World will tell you that you receive and then it's all right to give a little something. The world will teach you that there's a line between those who are strong and those who are weak. The world will teach you that you gain something, but then you stand the possibility of losing it. And then the world will teach you that you live and then you die. But Jesus says, if you're a Christian, you're going to have to do the opposite. In other words, I die in order to live again. Then he reminds Paul, when I'm weak, that's when I'm strong. I wish I had some Bible readers now. He reminds us that you give, then you receive. And that in order to gain, I've got to first learn how to lose. And it's that word loss that I want to close with today in dealing with the loss on earth, which is never easy. Holidays are getting ready to come up, and you're going to remember, and you're going to reflect on the good times. But it is in that moment of loss and grief, Pastor Mills, that will turn somehow, some kind of way, into some joy. Oh, you can lose something, but what you gain in the end is going to be worth it all. Let me just give you an example. Some of you lost some relationships, but you gained you back. Some of you lost some income or were furloughed during the pandemic, but you didn't lose anything in your house. Because I once was young. I'm getting a little bit older now. I ain't old yet, y'all. I'm getting a little bit older. But I have never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. Hey, some of y'all lost some friends along the way. Some people have pulled away from you, but you found out that there's a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. Some of y'all went through some pain and suffering that you couldn't tell anybody about, but you discovered you are a whole lot stronger than you thought you were. Everything you lose isn't necessarily a loss. Job said it like this: if a man die, shall he live again? All my appointed time, I am going to wait until my change comes. Well, you may not know the scripture, but some of y'all remember the late evangelist Luther Vandross. He said, let me see the real folk, a chair is still a chair, even when there's no one sitting there. A room is still a room. That's not in the hymn book. Don't look for it. Even when there's nothing there but gloom. But a room is not a house. And a house, I wish I had somebody over there be honest with me. I see you patting your foot. A house is not a home. You lost the house. But here's the good news. You still have a home. Do y'all remember the story of the young man who left prison, was on his way back home, Butch, and his father and his other brother were there, and his brother kept trying to get in his father's ear and say, hey, listen, you know brother steals, we might need to hide everything. And daddy said, well, now, wait a minute. His nature, his character may have changed since he'd been locked up. He said, I'm going to prove it to you. He said, I'm going to get an envelope and put a check in it, and I'm going to put it right over the mantelpiece, over the fireplace, next to the big TV that's got the little TV on top of it. Now, if you under 40, you don't know what I'm talking about. But some of y'all, thank you for putting your hands. Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you for being honest. Long story short, the young man came home, and the next morning that younger brother went downstairs. He looked, and he saw that envelope still sitting on the mantelpiece, and he said, Daddy, I told you. What did I tell you? I told you he was going to steal. The father calmly walked out of his room, went downstairs, looked at it, and bust out laughing. He said, Daddy, what you laughing for? I told you our brother was going to steal from us. He said, no, son, no. That's just the envelope. I got the check. I got the clothes, y'all. We got to go watch the Super Bowl. But I need to tell about three of y'all early last Sunday when we got out of church. And Cullie and her brothers and sisters got word that Sister Hudson had went on to be with the Lord. Isn't it good to know that in that casket is only the envelope, but Jesus got the check. And when I was a little boy, they used to tell me, if you live right, heaven belongs to you. If you talk right, heaven belongs to you. If you treat your neighbor right, heaven belongs to you. Is there anybody in here who helped me close this morning, this afternoon, by getting on your feet and saying, sleep on, Sister Hudson. We gonna miss the way you loved us. Sleep on, Sister Hudson. We gonna miss your kind and generous nature. But some glad morning, when this life is over, I'll fly away. I got to get out of here, y'all. But the hymnologist would say, when peace like a river attending my way, when sorrow like sea billow roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul. Sleep on, Sister Hudson. We gonna take care of your children. Sleep on, Sister Hudson. Your sister's gonna be all right. But one of these mornings, it won't be long. We all gonna fly away. If you know you're gonna fly away, don't y'all touch nobody. Point your hand at somebody and tell her, Sister Hudson's all right. Mother Hudson's all right. Tell them I'm all right too, because I know how to take a licking. Keep right on ticking. Yeah! We lost the house, but we still have a home. Where's that home? It's over in Beulah Land, where the wicked, come on, Pastor Mills, shall cease from troubling, and the weary will be at rest. And all of the saints of the ages, we're going to sit at his feet, and we're going to be blessed. Family, be encouraged. We cry, but we're excited too, because to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord.
Let the church say amen. Amen. Say amen again. I'm kind of homesick for a country to which I've never even been before. No sad goodbyes will there be spoken. Time won't anymore. I'm looking now across a river where my captive shall end inside. A few more days we'll have to labor, and then I'll take my heavenly flight, Beulah. For you, and someday on thee I'll stand. There my home shall be eternal.
Petitions are coming. We would ask everyone, with the exception of the family, if you would stand. Everyone except the family. Anybody going to be praying for this family in the days to come? I said, anybody going to be praying for this family in days to come? God, we thank you for the life of our dear sister. And we praise you and we thank you. Now she has left a legacy. Let us continue to live as she taught. Continue to work while it's day. For night cometh when no man will be able to work.
Day of rejoicing that will be.
onward to the prize before us. Soon his beauty will behold. Soon the pearly gates will open. We shall tread the streets of gold. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing there will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trust and serve him every day. Just one glimpse of him in glory will the toils of life prepare. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing!